Carol, recognize the member from Cambridge.
But I want my turn.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Merry Christmas. Thanks for that gift. I appreciate that. I'm happy to stand here on behalf of the RPC party here in this legislature to talk about the Healthy Home Renovation Tax Credit. And I share a lot of the comments on this side of the House with respect to this bill, that with particular respect to the fact that we have to have $10,000, or seniors have to have $10,000 to be able to afford a renovation of the kind that they're looking for. If we look at how much these lifts cost, they're very expensive. Any modifications are very expensive. You have to have that money in the bank before you can actually do that. And, Mr. Speaker, quite frankly, if you have the money in the bank to spend on a renovation of this nature, you're probably going to do it whether there's a tax credit or not, because it's about improving the quality of life. It's about improving, and sometimes even improving, the longevity of life. And people, folks who have the money to do that are going to do it whether they have the money or not, Mr. Speaker, or the tax credit or not. But I want to spend some time talking today about the beauty of this place, Mr. Speaker. We are, as I mentioned earlier today, 107 men and women who have the privilege and distinction of serving in this place. Out of 13 million Ontarians, 107 people. And that actually strikes me as, when I heard Speaker Peters actually say that, former Speaker Peters, I should say, Mr. Speaker, say that for the first time, that I think was the moment where it started to sink in for when I became a member of provincial parliament. This whole thing was a long journey, a journey that all of us had to make, and we've all had different twists and turns. But it was at that moment, sitting in this place, this beautiful place, looking at the great features of this legislature, looking at the eagle and the owl and all the sculptures and all the carvings of the wood in this place, that it really started to sink in that I was the member of provincial parliament for Cambridge. Before I came to this place, Mr. Speaker, I was a university professor. I have a PhD in political science, and so I had a long interest in studying parliamentary institutions. And a lot of my favorite theorists are still at the back of my mind when I come to this place. For example, A.V. Dicey was a man who was very well versed in our parliamentary institutions. He talked at length about the supremacy of Parliament, the supremacy of our parliamentary institutions. We are in a place that makes the laws on behalf of the citizens of the province of Ontario. We do that every day that we sit here, and we talk to constituents when we're not in this place. And so, thinking about that, in the beauty of this building, that we are a supreme body making laws on behalf of Ontarians, really strikes me even further, Mr. Speaker. Blackstone talked also about the supremacy of this place. He suggested that that our legislature and parliamentary institutions right across the world have a capacity to do anything. And he cited the example, do anything except make a man a woman and a woman a man, Mr. Speaker. That was his famous quote, and I think modern technology even allows us to do that if we so permit. That just speaks to the power of what we do in this legislature, the power that we have as legislators talking about laws and policies and regulations that govern citizens. It is a very important thing. We have we are very privileged to have a seat here to talk about those things that are important to our constituents and are important to the future of the province of Ontario. So, Mr. Speaker, another one of those famous philosophers that I like to follow is a gentleman by the name of Edmund Burke. Edmund Burke had a famous speech at Bristol that he gave in 1776. 1776 was a long, long time ago, certainly a long time than we weren't around that time, except maybe the member for Durham was around back then, but, you know, not really sure. But Mr. Speaker, he talked about the role of the NPP, or the MP. He's talking about British Parliament. He talked about that role as having a dual function. a dual function of representing constituents in your riding, and the other function being representing the interests of the whole, representing the interests of the entire country. He was talking about Britain, but we can extrapolate that. Not only are we as MPPs here in this legislature representing our constituents, but we're also governing the whole of the province of Ontario, which makes that my seat in this place even more special, given all of that I have learned in my educational career. And, Mr. Speaker, that's exactly what I've been doing since I was elected, as representing my constituents. We have a resolution passed in this House that talks about holding the government accountable for their infrastructure announcements, particularly related to hospital expansions. I tabled a bill yesterday, Mr. Speaker, that's called the Protection of Child Care Centres Act. Hopefully that we can talk reasonably about moving that to second and third reading going forward. These are important aspects of what I have done in this House to represent my constituents, and I hope to continue to do that in my seat here. Mr. Speaker, I've achieved a lot of success in my 32 years of age. I have a PhD in political science, as I mentioned earlier, achieved the highest academic honour. I ran a small business, and I even published my first book this year, Mr. Speaker. But, Mr. Speaker, the one thing that I'm most proud of is being a husband to my wife, Kate, and a father to my two boys. My oldest boy, his name is Alexander. He's a bright kid. He just turned 4 in November, and he's already reading. He actually got to read his first book to his class last week, Mr. Speaker. My youngest boy, his name is Aiden, and he's only 7 months old, Mr. Speaker, and I just got a video from my wife this week. He started to commando crawl. This is a very big milestone in his life, and something that unfortunately I had to see on video and not in person. So, Mr. Speaker, that speaks to a lot of the sacrifice that members in this House have to make to actually be in this place. And I think it's very important to understand that we do make a sacrifice to be here, but we're doing that because of the privilege that that is awarded to us by our constituents. And at that sacrifice, in the name of public service, to talk about the future of the province of Ontario is a very important thing that we should never lose sight of. And despite all the partisanship we often see in this place, and we hear that a lot, that our politics has become too partisan, we should never lose sight of the fact that each one of us in this place has made a tremendous sacrifice to be here, and we should always be considerate of others who have made a similar sacrifice as well. And, Mr. Speaker, that sacrifice came to my parents as well. I want to give special mention to my parents, who immigrated to this country like many Ontarians did in the 1960s. They immigrated in the 1960s. And why did they immigrate to Ontario? They came here to give a better life for their kids and for their grandkids. And, you know, I think that when I look my kids in my eye, when I see their faces, I want to be able to say that I gave them and made a similar sacrifice to make sure that their lives would be better, Mr. Speaker. That's the reason why I decided to run for the MP, to be MPP for Cambridge. I'm so blessed to have the privilege to serve my constituents and to be able to look my children in the eye to say that I have done everything that I possibly could in my life to make theirs better. And we should never lose sight of that goal, Mr. Speaker, that goal of making our children and our grandchildren have the future that we had, at least as good, if not better. And we should be doing that on a daily basis and considering that as we go forward. So we all make a tremendous sacrifice. We all know that we have our ideas about how we can improve life for Ontario. And I look forward to having those debates about the future, Mr. Speaker, because that is, in essence, what we do here. And finally, Mr. Speaker, I want to say thank you to the people of Cambridge and North Dumfries for giving me the opportunity to serve here. I'm proud to serve my great riding, a riding that is formed by the City of Cambridge and the Township of North Dumfries. And it's a great place to live, to work, and to raise a family. I look forward to discussing ideas that will improve their lives, in addition to improving the lives of all people in this great province. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker.
Questions and comments?